All right, guys, welcome to the stream. My name is Ryan. I am the tournament organizer here at Four Horsemen Comics and Gaming. And we're going to be playing some Legacy today. Oh. Hold on. We got to kill all the sound everywhere. Yes, Brian. This is Ryan. Yes, Brian. This is Ryan. Aha! Found the source of the feedback. We are good to go. Let's play some Magical Gatherings. Today we're going to play my favorite format. And my favorite deck. We're going to play a little Legacy with Maverick. I'm going to go ahead and try to find a match. If that takes a little bit, then we will go over the deck list. I don't know how quickly you can find an opponent. Oh, rather quickly. Hold on. Gotta bring... not really recently. It was about 3 weeks ago. Yes, recently. Let's see here. Just getting set up and adjusted here. Mm-hmm. Yes. I won the dice roll and I would like to play first. Okay, I think we're good to go. Alright, taking a look at my hand. We've got two lands. We've got a turn one play with Mom. Or get a Dryad Arbor off the Green Sun Zenith. We've got two removal spells. We've got turn two play with Teague or the Green Sun. I like this. I think we've got some action against fair decks and combo decks since we have Teague and the Abrupt Decays. So I'm pretty happy with this. We're going to keep it. So the first question is, what are we going to cast on turn one? Hold on. I need to turn this stop off. All right. Stop's turned off. Do we want to cast the Mom, or do we want a Green Sun for a Dryad Arbor? Since we don't know what we're playing against, I am going to go ahead and play the Mom first and save the Green Sun Zenith in case we need to get a specific Hate Bear, like a Pride Mage or a Scavenging Ooze. Teague would also be a thing if he weren't in my hand already. And if we end up playing against a fair deck, well, then we can just use that to get a... neither reliquary later. The more pressing question to me is what do I fetch for? Because if we're playing against a wasteland deck and I fetch for a Savannah and it gets wastelanded, then we might be in an awkward position mana wise. I might have to on my next turn use that Green Sun Zenith to get a Dryad Arbor. Though I suppose if he does just wasteland me on his turn, then I'm ahead on the board. So we're going to go ahead and do that. We're going to use Verdant Catacombs to get a Savannah and cast Mother of Rooms. We'll save the Windswept Teeth because that can get us either basic in our deck. We have one Forest and one Plains just in case we feel like we need to start fetching basics. Go Ma! Go Ma, and then we're just going to F6 through both turns here. Ancient Tomb, maybe Eldrazi. Grim Monolith, oh no. Trenosphere, oh no. Oh no, okay, so it looks like we're playing against a mud deck. It could be some sort of Eldrazi variant. It could be some sort of Stax prison-ish deck. It's probably mud. Alright, we drew a land, which is good, which means we have three lands, so we can cast the Ings under this Trenosphere. Can't cast anything this turn, so we are just going to play the Windswept Teeth and pass. We may use it to get Dryad Arbor at the end of his turn. Since we're probably playing against a colorless deck, and Mom doesn't have anything to protect except for herself, I think it's safe to just get in there, especially since we may be facing down an ensnaring bridge at some point during this match, so we want to get in as much damage as we can before the bridge comes down. And also, it's not irrelevant that our opponent is playing Ancient Tombs, multiple Ancient Tombs, and will be doing a lot of damage to themselves. Thran Dynamite! Oh! Oh my, what is our opponent doing? I suppose this is a mud deck. Another Grim Monolith. This is terrifying. Alright, we might be seeing, like, a Steel Hellkite or something terrible coming down on us soon. What else would be terrible? Sundering Titan would be terrible. Blight Steel Colossus would be terrible. I'm really scared. Caracas could be relevant. Sometimes some of the things they play are legendary. None of the, like, big ones are, unless he's got, like, Eldrazi. So we're gonna keep that in our hands for now. So I can play a Bayou, and I can Abrupt Decay one of these things. Abrupt Decaying the Thran Dynamo, I can't, because that's four. The Grim Monolith, no point, because I can't take him off both. I can only take him off one. I could Abrupt Decay the Trinisphere, but I'm actually kind of already in the one spell a turn area, so I think I'm just going to play Bayou. Kind of tempted to play Gaddock Teague, because it's possible that some of his payoff spells are non-creatures, like Karn or Ugin. I'm really scared of Ugin. Alright. And if we play Gaddock Teague, I might just keep Mom up off on the off chance that he has Dismembers in his deck. Alright, so what's most likely? Like, there's lots of payoff spells he can play. I don't know what he's playing. The odds that he has an Ugin or a Karn is pretty scary. There's also the, Alright, well, we're just going to play Teague, because Teague. That's reason enough. Go, go, Gaddock Teague. You think, Brain? I mean, I'm typically down for the mana denial strategy, but he's got the Thran Dynamo and two Ancient Tombs. Alright, do your worst. I have Ugin. Yep. Oh, he does have Eldrazi. Terrified. I am terrified. It'll be a miracle if we win this game. Alright. So, now that I know he has Eye of Ugin, I think Abrupt Decaying that Grim Monolith might be a good idea. So we can Abrupt Decay the untapped one on this turn. Possibly Abrupt Decay the tapped one on the next turn, or any other mana rock he may play. That's 7, not 10, huh? I don't know what you mean by that. So, first things first. Go, go, Gaddock Teague. Probably should attack with Dryad Arbor 2. Whoops. That's okay. I'll use Dryad Arbor to pay for Abrupt Decay, that way we can leave open Caracas. Of course, if he plays Ulamog the Ceaseless Hunger, he can just exile the Caracas because it's a cast trigger. Ugh, that's disgusting. Okay. Yes. Alright, main phase. Play Caracas. Abrupt Decay the untapped Grim Monolith. Leaving up Mother Runes in case he plays Dismember. Leaving up Caracas for Eldrazi shenanigans. What is he doing? Just floating mana? No, because he tapped Ancient Tomb. What is going on? Okay, he's untapping, gaining his life back. It's hilarious how that works. Taps three and down a mouth. Oh, this is so much mana. I guess he's just using it to activate Eye of Ugin. Yes, that is what he's doing. And now we get to see what will kill us. Ulamog the Ceaseless Hunger. Oh. Terrified. Straight terrified. I don't even know how much that guy costs. Straight don't know. I don't think I've ever had that card cast against me in my life. Googles tells me that Glimmer Post Vomit. Yeah, we'll always yield to that trigger. I guess he has enough to cast Ulamog. Yes. And he will, I assume, exile the Caracas. And probably doesn't matter after that. And I can't info block the guy with Mom because he's colorless. Probably just dead here. What are your targets? Mom and Caracas. Okay. So that tells me that he may not care about Teague. Oh, okay. I didn't know what the mana cost of Ulamog was. This is my first time playing against this card. No, second time. I played again. Ulamog knocked me out of day two of SCG Philly. Stupid Enchantress. Okay. So we can F6. Alright, Pride Mage. Yeah, I think we just had to draw Swords to Plowshares, which we didn't, of course. I guess we have another turn to draw Swords to Plowshares. Could Abrupt Decay something. Probably just play Pride Mage. I could Green Sun for Knight. I'm going to Green Sun for Knight. When all else fails, just Knight of the Reliquary. Oh, I can't because the Gaddock Teak. Well, that was embarrassing. Alright, so. Derp. Okay. So let's cast a Primate. Say Meow Kitty. F6 because we're not attacking into that wall of meat. What you gonna do, Uli? God. Okay, so he attacks. Does he have any other abilities? Yeah, the milling thing. I've got 46 cards in my library. I've got 17 life, so that's 2 attacks. He activate. What does this guy do? If you have fewer than 7 cards. Ugh. Gross. Okay, so I basically can't win here. Because let's say... So the plan was, like, he attacks with Ulamog twice, and I kill him, and I attack twice, and I win. I have enough life to take the hits, or enough cards in library to take the hits, blah, blah, blah. But with Kozilek, like, I can't even do that because he has a blocker, and if I draw Swords to Plowshares, he's going to gain 12 life anyway. All right, so this game is over. Let's sideboard. Alright, so we are playing against Mud. A little more Eldrazi-ish build of it. Alright, so we definitely like Reclamation Sage. Winter Orb. Winter Orb is interesting. Because he is a big mana deck. I guess it doesn't really affect things like Ayavukan because those don't have to be untapped. Pithing Needle's good because it doesn't affect mana abilities. Never mind. Pithing Needle is not good. Alright. Teak is good. As long as you remember things. Thoughtseize seem good. Canonist, Enlightened Tutor. We might bring in Enlightened Tutor. Just because the Winter Orb Armageddon seems wonderful. Okay. So I like that. The Swords and Plowshares are okay. Not great. Like the Dorks. The Moms seem bad. He may board into removal spells post-board. But I don't know if his removal spells might be Warping Whale. Or Dismember. But I don't think I should keep Mom in just because he might have Dismember. So, Moms are coming out. Pride Mage, Teague, Abrupt Decay, like, all this seems fine. I should bring something out, though. So, trimming here, the Skooze is a safe bet to come out. The Thalias can probably come out because I'm actually bringing in some instants and sorceries to play against him. And that seems fine. I like it. Let's go. Test. Huh? Okay. Yes, I would like to play first. God, it's 11. Ew! Actually, So I'm kind of tempted to keep this because I'm on the play. So I can Green Sun for Dryad Arbor and then just blow up whatever he plays with Reclamation Sage because he'll probably play a Mana Rock. And I also have a Wasteland to follow that up. Probably shouldn't keep 5 Landers. I kind of like it. Alright, sure. Keep. I like it. Alright, so... sometimes these decks play Wasteland. Sometimes they don't. So you just kind of got to pick at the beginning, am I playing around Wasteland or am I not? I think we have enough lands here that we're good not playing around Wasteland. I am going to lead on the Verdant Catacombs because, as I said earlier, the Windswept Heaths get both my basics if I decide I need to do that for some reason. So we're going to get Savannah. We're going to Green Sun for Dryad Arbor. Yes, X is 0. Dryad Arbor. And we're just going to F6. Hopefully he goes like Ancient Tomb Mana Rock. Yep, just like that. Although hopefully he doesn't have a follow-up to this unless it's like another Mana Rock. Okay, it's another Grim Monolith. So I'm going to target the untapped one. Oh god, what's happening? Okay, 309 miles. That's the one. That's the one. No! What's happening? Please stop! Please stop, you're a bad man! I did keep it, Paul. Voltaic Key. Oh no. This is bad. Sometimes when you play the fair green-white deck, you just feel like you're getting manhandled. That's because you are. Alright. Oh no, look at this. This is disgusting. What? This is ridiculous. You gonna play your whole hand? Well, if his whole hand is Mana Rocks and like one piece of business, and then I get to blow up the piece of business with Reclamation Sage, then I actually like the spot I'm in. Thought not seer. God damn! God! Blah! Okay. This is fine. This is fine. It's not fine. It's really not fine. Bye-bye, Reclamation Sage. I barely knew ye. Alright, we're just going to F6 here. Probably should have already F6'd. I think I already did F6. Alright, so he took the Reclamation Sage. Predictable. And we draw Wasteland. Yay! Well, I guess we Wasteland him. Bye-bye, Ancient Tomb. Any reason to do it on his turn? Because he might tap it in his upkeep to play a Warping Wheel. Okay, so we'll stop on his turn. Say okay. Can't talk into that wall. 4-4. I can't scoop, Paul. This is game two and I'm down a game. Alright, so stopped in his upkeep. Bye-bye, Ancient Tomb. Yep, he's floating too. Yeah, maybe I shouldn't have done that. God, just totally dropping the ball against this guy. Okay. So we let him untap his Grim Monolith. That's fine. This guy. I'm not dead to just a Thought Knots here, though. I have a lot of draws. So he does need something else to really to kill me here, because I've got, yeah, like, Knight's a pretty good draw. So if I fetch, it's a 5/5. So that's what we're going to do. Lololol. I'm not afraid of Emrakul. Come at me, Emrakul. Go, go, Knight. Ha! Take that, Thought Knots here. Okay, so he's got one card in hand. He's got all the mana, but he has to find something else, because this Thought Knots here is not going to be enough. Unless he has a Dismember, like, right here. Alright, so we just F6. I forgot what I was doing. I was doing something. Well, he's got something. Ulamog, you say? Exile my creatures, you say? Well, good play, sir. No! You can't have this cloud post. That's what I say to you, sir. Well, we're dead here. We will, we'll continue, because this is, because I'm down the game. So, but, we're pretty dead here, people. All right, Paul! No. No, we won't scoop. Play on. F6 on. Nope. All right. We're done. GG's. Good job, M. Little 1980. Hey, we're born in the same year. All right. Let's jump into another one, shall we? I wish you would default over to this monitor. Why? Because I asked nicely. Alright, we get to be on the play. We're playing against Tenko. Let me get rid of this. Three lands, removal spell, two mobs, knights. I like it. It's fine. We'll keep it. Not the best. It's kind of, I don't like leading on non-basics when I'm playing a mom, because I don't, like, I know, like, if they wasteland me, then I'm technically ahead on board. I just don't like, I like wastelanding people. I don't like getting wastelanded. It's just me. All right, it's gonna update my Excel sheet saying that I lost 0-2 to Mud. La la la. One loss. Two games, zero wins, two losses. Takes my match win percentage to 0%. My game win percentage to 0%. Awesome. Alright, let's F6 through this guy's turn. Play in a league? I don't have time for a league. I'm just playing pickup games. I gotta go to the gym before I have to pick up my son. Gots to do the body right. I will stream a leak at some point soon, though. Alright, so Polluted Delta into Underground Sea. He is playing Storm! Oh my god, it's Storm! I'm dead! I love this format. Look at this. You don't know, man. I could have Force of Will. I could be playing, like, Esper Mom. Get out of here. It's a little weird that he played out the LEDs before the Ponder. I wonder if this is Ant, or maybe it's Tess. It's hard to say. Oh, look. People are talking on my Facebook chat. Who's streaming? Sounds like Ryan. Yes, Diamato and Wyatt, it is me. Haha, it is Ryan. What the heck, Ron? You guys suck. Alright, so that was a little weird. He played out his two LEDs in his pedal, pondered and passed turn. Usually, when they play out the rocks like that, one of two things is, one, they're going off and you're dead. Or two, they're playing around hand disruption. Could be the case that he's playing around hand disruption because I led on scrubland. That still seems a little odd to me. So, based on the cards I've seen, I want to say this is a storm deck, either Ant or Tess. But I'm going to try to not zero in on that. This could be some other kind of deck that doesn't need to generate storm, and thus that's why he played out the LEDs in the pedal. So, what do? Alright. Whatever deck he's playing, the Sword of the Plowshare is probably not good. So what we could do is we could play Mom and Dryad Arbor and attack with the first Mom for one. The question is it worth leaving the Mom up to Activator in case he plays removal spells? Usually any deck that's playing Lion's Eye Diamond and Lotus Petal doesn't have main deck removal spells. Although, I mean, it could be like a Burning Wish deck, so maybe a little Burning Wish into Chain of Vapors or something like that. It's really hard. I'm not going to scoop, Paul! You guys are supposed to be my friends! Thank you, Diamato. I appreciate the support. So, maybe we should just play conservatively and go on the Merit Lage plan here, because we can play... Next turn, we can play Stage and Knight, make Merit Lage on turn 3, attack on turn 4. Surely I'll be dead by then. I don't really see a better option than just playing my second Mom and playing the Dryad Arbor, though. So that's what we're going to do. Do we attack? I mean, even if he is, like, a Burning Wish deck, there's nothing here that he wants to bounce, so we might as well get damage in. It's not like I have a Thalia or a Gaddock T or something out. So I like getting in here. It also means we get to F6. Alright. Do yours, sir. God, I'm so dead. Ron, stop it. I'm not playing Door to Nothingness. This is not funny. Where did my music go? I need my tunes. Where'd you go, girl? Yes, I'm still listening. Oh my god. Okay. Alright, well, oh god, I wasn't even paying attention. I was looking for Pandora. Alright, so he pondered and he played a bayou. You know what, Paul, you're not wrong. Alright, so we're not dead. He played a land and he pondered. So he's setting up for something. And I drew Sword of Fire and Ice, which I cannot cast and equip. I think we're just going to stay on the Knight of the Reliquary plan here. I don't want to play the stage. I'm going to use the Verdant Catacombs to cast Knight. Reason being, I don't want to give him the information. Because, one, he may not be thinking Merit Liege when I cast Knight. And even if he is, he may think I have to activate Knight twice, and that gives him an extra turn. So we're just going to play Verdant Catacombs. We're going to fetch for Savannah. I don't think this is a Wasteland deck. Not that we'd be playing around Wasteland anymore. We're playing around not dying currently. That is the goal. Alright, so here's Knight. So next turn, I can make Merit Liege. Have Mom up to protect it in case he has like Chain of Vapors or something. Have two Moms up to protect it. Technically, I could attack with a Mom here, but since we're on the Merit Liege plan, I'm just not going to do that. We're going to leave two up to protect the Knight. So we're not going to F6 because we have Moms. This guy's really got to be on Storm. It's just weird that he played out those LEDs. I guess it is also weird that he fetched for this Underground Sea on his first turn, since I was on the play. So you can probably assume I'm on some sort of Wasteland deck, since I led on Scrubland Mom. Alright, he's cracking. Alright, we are most likely dead here. Although he only has three cards in hand after this. Passed on Flames, though. Alright, so we're just going to say okay. We're not F6ing. I am four color Force of Will deck. Alright, so he has four Black and Pool from the Lotus Petal in the Dark Ritual. Five, tapping his lands. So if he has three cards, Storm counts one. Okay, so Dark Petition. Dark Petition for Past in Flames, I guess. Maybe he has an Infernal Tutor in his hand, and then maybe he'll be able to cobble it together. I'm not a Storm player. I watch a lot of Storm, played against a lot of Storm. I'm thinking he's Ant, not Tess, because one of how slow he was, two of he's, looks like he's playing for Past in Flames here. Okay, so no, he probably searched for Infernal Tutor. And he's going to crack LED on the stack. Has a whole bunch of black mana. I need to have that storm counter up. How do you put the storm counter up? Settings. I don't know how to put the storm counter up. But he can probably just chain tutors now and then kill tendrils. I don't know. He's going for ad nauseum. I don't think he had enough mana to chain tutors and then go for tendrils. Adonaz. This should be good enough to get him there, because he actually doesn't need to find that much off the ad nauseum. And he's shown enough Cabal rituals and he's got Threshold. He probably just needs to find another tutor or the tendrils itself. Yeah, so he's got tendrils. So I should be dead here. I'm just going to make him do it. It's good to make Storm players do it, because sometimes they don't have it or they don't see it. So unless you're pressed for time, I generally recommend making them play it out. Also, watching it helps you learn the deck. Yeah, you're going to duress me. Maybe I should have conceded to the duress so he didn't know about the Dark Depths combo, but that's probably pretty minuscule. And honestly, Dark Depths is a card consider boarding out against Storm anyway. So here's the tendrils. We'll let the Storm trigger resolve. There's 10 copies. I'm at 19, so we can concede the game. We're going to game 2. Dang, all these combo decks. Oh, all right.
sideboard. We got a pretty solid plan against Storm, though. There's just not much we can do if they go off on the first two turns. All right, so we want Diggadic Teague. La la la. We want the Thalia. We want the two Aethersworn Canonists and the Enlightened Tutor to go, which is functionally another Aethersworn Canonist. We want the Thought Seizes. We may want the Zealous Persecution and the Engineered Plague. They do like to go sometimes. It obviously depends on the player, but sometimes they like to go with Empty the Warrens against us. Okay, so we leave in Moms. We board out the Swords. The only reason you ever leave in Swords is against Xanted Swarm and we don't play counter spells. All the Mana Dorks are good. Stoneforge Mystics usually come out. Thaddeus are good. Scavenging News is good. Scrub Ranger is good. Sylvan Library is good. Abrupt Decays are bad. Okay, and that gives us 7. Derp, derp, derp. 61. So here, either we trim on Stoneforge Mystics, Knights, a Pride Mage, or Dark Depths. Bye, Paul. So, what we're going to do is we're going to take out the two Pride Mages, and we're going to board these in for Empty the Warrens. And then, as the 61st last card we need to board out, we're going to take out the Dark Depths. Because at least the Thespian Stapes taps for mana. Yes, I would like to play first. Alright, so... this is so close. I would say this hand is perfect. I don't have any black mana on turn one, so I can't lead on Thoughtseize. Which is really rough. We do get to play Deathrite Shaman, and then if he cracks a fetch or if I draw a fetch, my turn two could be Thoughtseize into Thalia, which is really strong. We also have Zealous Persecution and Green Sun Zenith, which could go and get. We could also Green Sun for Gaddock Teague on turn two. And we have the Persecution in case he goes Goblins. So I like this. We're going to keep. Just wish one of those lands was a fetch land. Alright, so he Mulligan down to 6. Alright. Savannah, Deathrite Shaman. F6. F6. Duress, so probably take the Thoughtseize. He could take the Zealous Persecution. He could take the Green Sun Zenith if he's scared of Teague. Took the Thoughtseize. So that actually makes our plan a little more simple. He's going to probe. Haha! One less Thalia attack. Probe again. This guy's greedy. I like it. Hey, Sylvan Library. He didn't crack a fetch, and I didn't draw a fetch. Means I can't use Deathrite Shaman for mana. Can either Green Sun for one, which would only get us Dryad Arbor, Noble Hierarch, or Deathrite Shaman, so that's not what we want to do. Or play Library or Thalia. So we're going to play Thalia because it'll attack. The Sylvan Library is probably not going to get played this game. We'll see, though. And then we're going to get in there for one with our Squire.
Now, Thalia, usually one Thalia is almost never enough to actually beat Storm, because they just have to, like, set up a end of your turn, abrupt decay, disfigure, chain of vapors, or whatever, untap, kill you. So the key to actually beating Storm is attacking them on multiple axes. Various axes would be a permanent based hate, their life total, their graveyard, the stack, or the hand. And Maverick is set up to attack them on all of these axes, with the exception of the stack. We're going to F6. So that means we're vulnerable in the first two turns, depending on if we're on the play or the draw. But then we have a lot of play after that. So the Thalia is good, but it's important to follow it up by attacking on the different axes. We do have the... We had the Deathrite Shaman and the Thoughtseize, but we're just missing the black mana. It's a little rough. There's a Pluto Delta, though. That'll help. Ponder! Hopefully we're not dead this turn. Now watch. I'm going to draw something. A land, so I can just, like, Green Sun for Night here. No, no, I wouldn't be able to Green Sun for Night. Because of Thalia. Never mind. Ooh, cookie crisps. Delectable cookie crisp cereal. Thought Seize. Wouldn't it be great if we could cast that? And cast a creature like an Anthrosworn Canonist. Let's not be greedy, though. Alright. So we're going to go ahead and cast Thoughtseize. He's tapped out so he can't raid Storm in response, so that's great. Make a black. Tap this. Thoughtseize. Choose Tinko. Ho ho. Ho 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 ho. Okay. So, Abrupt Decay, Infernal Tutor, LED, Ponder. So, he doesn't have double on anything, which is good. He has a removal spell, a business spell, mana, and a cantrip. My gut is just like, take the Abrupt Decay, ride this Thalia to victory. There's also an argument to taking the Tutor, because then he has to find another piece of business. And also the LED. It's usually really hard for this deck to go off without LED. I definitely don't want to take the Ponder. I am going to take the Abrupt Decay, though, because also equally important to attacking them on multiple axes is to clock them while you're disrupting them, which is what Thalia does, which is why she's like, my bae. So we are going to type in these other cards into our chat. So we know what's in his hand. And then we're going to select the Abrupt Decay. We can't cast anything else this turn because we didn't draw land. So we're just going to attack with Thalia. And then we're going to have six. Ponder. Alright, so we're F6 through his turn as well. Take the Ponder off the list. So he has Pluto Delta, Infernal Tutor, LED, and he'll have two mystery cards after this Ponder is resolved. Alright, I need to bring this back up to see what he did. He chose not to shuffle, which is bad. Alright, yeah, so he found another way to kill the Thalia, which also killed the Deathrite Shaman, which is bad. Massacre. Dryad Armor, huh? So I actually think to crack the Delta, no. So we know his whole hand. It's Delta Tutor LED. So, I seriously doubt we're dead. He has no initial mana. So, we kind of get to rebuild here. F6. You guys get to see how Sylvan Library works on Magic Online. It's a crazy. We have six.
I also get to Green Sun for Gaddick Teak on my turn, which is pretty sweet.
Shouldn't be able to kill me here unless he has some insane draw.
Usually, insane draws start with a brainstorm. We shall see. So he has the combo of the tutor and LED, infernal tutor and LED.
But he needs some initial mana to get it started, like some rituals.
So gets rid of the delta. He has plenty of mana with his land, but he needs something that also generates storm. Okay, so he's playing out the LED, which means he's probably playing around cards like Thoughtseize. Like I said, LED's really important to the plan. So he just has the Infernal Tutor and a mystery card. Looks like he's casting Tutor. He may be just getting another copy of whatever in his hand, or he may just crack the LED here. Maybe he's casting some other 2-mana black spell. Alright, so here's Tutor. It's on the stack. Is he holding priority? Yep, okay. Discards Past in Flames. That was a good draw. But he doesn't have any red because he cracked it for black. Is he going for Ad Nauseam? But then he has no floating mana. Yep, he's going for Ad Nauseam. I mean, I guess... This seems weird. Alright, so he gets an LED. Which is good. As long as he has, like... a pedal to go with the LED, then he can discard his whole hand, make 4 red mana, flashback past the flames, and then everything in his graveyard. But see, then he still needs an initial black. I don't know. This is weird. Storm's hard. I'm going to have to bring the chat back up and look at everything he's revealing. Alright, so he does play Burning Wish. He could be just an ant build. He seems slow. I don't want to say he's Tess. I haven't seen any of the red rituals, so he might just be an ant deck that plays Burning Wish, which you do see sometimes. Sometimes for like toolboxy sideboard cards. Sometimes for extra business. Usually both. Okay, so he went down to 2. He's playing 2 LEDs. So he's got the mana to flash back the Past in Flames. So actually, with 2 LEDs, he can make red and black. And then discard, I'm assuming he's got rituals. So he can discard everything in his hands, which he did. And then he can flash back Past in Flames. Then he's got the rituals. He could probably just cast a bunch of rituals. Couple rituals and the Infernal Tutor and kill me. So I actually don't mind losing to Storm that much because I get to watch them play and try to play along at home. It's kind of fun. It's a deck that I would consider. It's like one of the few combo decks I would consider building. Nope, he didn't have it apparently. Alright, so back to the sideboard. Sometimes you do just get free wins against the deck because they goof up or they just don't have it. So, looking at my sideboard configuration, I don't think there's anything I want to change. The Winter Orb is something maybe I should consider. This does cut them off of mana, but then again, I'm also playing. I want to cast multiple spells against them to... It's hard. I don't know if I like Winter Orb against them or not. So we're just going to run it back. Alright, well... we don't have white mana. But... 2 Thoughtseizes and a Gaddick Teak. I don't think we can turn this down. Definitely cannot. Alright, so he kept 7. I'm going to keep 7. Does hurt that we get to be on the draw. Especially since he could go probe whatchamacallit, Cabal Therapy. We'll see. Alright, so plays Delta LED. Doesn't necessarily mean I'm dead. He could just be playing around hand disruption. And the ponder makes me think that that is the case. Ponder! Ponder, 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 ponder. I really shouldn't whistle while I'm on stream. Second LED. And looks like he's passing. He is passing. Okay. Alright, so Dryad Arbor or Thoughtseize? I think we're going to cast Thoughtseize. Cabal Therapy, Dark Ritual, Brainstorm, blah, 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 blah. Okay. Well, Definitely not taking the mana. Brainstorm is the strongest card here, and it's going to help him find what he needs to win. There's no point in taking the Dark Rituals and the Lotus Petals because he has plenty of mana. He already has a land and 2 LEDs in play. The Cabal Therapies, he'd have to... It would suck if he took Gaddock or Thoughtseize, but he'd have to know to take them. And if he may call one and I still have the other, and I may not be able to cast Gaddock anyway. So we're going to take the Brainstorm. We're going to make a note that he has Therapy, Lotus Petal, and Dark Ritual. And that's all we can do. So we're going to go ahead and F6 through his turn. We don't play counter magic, so we don't have to pretend. I like not pretending. Alright, so there's a Lotus Petal. Got it. Dark Ritual, Cabal Therapy. I don't know, he may just want to... Honestly, I think if he Cabal's there, Cabal Therapy's here, he probably names Thalia anyway. So I'm pretty happy with taking the Brainstorm there. I'm guessing he didn't draw anything haymakerish, although I'm not really sure what you would draw there. The tutor, maybe? Yeah, I guess if you... Because you don't even... Alright, so here's Cabal Therapy. I'm going to bring the chat back up to see what he names. He casts Cabal Therapy, naming... or targeting me. It's gonna I'm F6, so it's going to resolve. So now he's probably scrolling through a list of cards, trying to decide what to pick. He names Surgical Extraction. That's weird. I guess maybe he's not too familiar with Maverick. That was an odd choice. Alright, so the only card we know is Dark Ritual, which he casts. That's bad. That's real bad. He drew an Infernal Tutor. Oh my god. He drew that freaking Passing Flames last game, and he drew the Infernal Tutor. I guess he did Ponder on his first turn. What'd he do? Did he just... Okay, so he cracked those, all for black, so he's probably getting ad nauseum or... Yep. He even has 2 black floating. Storm count's already at 5. So this is looking really bad. Maybe he chose Surgical Extraction because he felt like he could win this turn. And Surgical is the only card that I could possibly actually have in my hand to interact with him on this turn. And if that was the case, that makes sense. That's very logical. Because he knew that if I didn't have something to interact with him on his turn, that I wouldn't get to untap. Which does most definitely seem like I am dead. Yeah, so this one resolves and he's just going to go get tendrils off of this one. And then that's the match. Massacre. Searched for Massacre. Okay, but he already had tendrils. Okie dokie. So that's that match. We're going to go ahead and concede. I'm going to update my my thingy. I have an Excel sheet that tracks all the games and matches I play against particular matchups. And I've been keeping track of it ever since I've been playing Maverick on Moto, which isn't very long. That's my second match against Ant. The first one I won, so that takes my match and game win percentage up to down to 50%. I should probably stop streaming now. Need to go to the gym. Didn't do any cleaning. Need to pick up Drake in a little less than 2 hours. Also need to eat lunch. Well, maybe just one more match. Perhaps just one more. Yes, I would like to play first. Alright. 3 lands, 2 removal spells, 2 creatures. If we're not keeping this hand, why are we playing Maverick? Alright, we're on the play. I'm just going to play a fetch land and go. Potentially play around Wasteland here. This doesn't play around Stifle, but Wasteland is much more common than Stifle. So we're just going to play it like that. So we have the option of getting Dryad Arbor at the end of his turn. Top miracles. Okay, another match was a mistake. This is not going to be a quick one. Okay. Yes, I am not going to counter your top. I have stuff to do. I should have just stopped here. Alright, so now the question is, do we get Dryad Arbor? Which we're not going to, because we don't want a Terminus taking our lands, and so we don't want to fetch for our Dryad Arbor until we're actually going to attack with it. Ew, that's gross. Alright, so game one against Miracles, I'm not worried about cards like Ruination and Blood Moon. Something we're going to play around in game two. Game one, we're not going to play around it. If they're a madman and playing it in the main board, then we can't win. So here's Pride Mage. We're just going to F6 through both turns here. He led on Tundra, which implies that he doesn't have any sticks in his opening hand, or maybe he wants to make a counterbalance. May have the counterbalance and just didn't play it because I play the Pride Mage. It's hard to say. Alright, so we're just going to play What's Up Teeth and attack with Pride Mage. If he swords it, if he kills it with swords, I will play another creature. If the Pride Mage lives, I will just pass. It's really important to not overextend into a Terminus, because that's how you lose this matchup. I am really tempted to play Mom. There's a lot of upside to playing Mom if there's not a Terminus. But I think we're just going to make him answer our first threat, and then we'll worry about play, because we could play Mom and Knight in the same turn. And of course, his sword's at the end step.
So this is probably an instance where I'm going to think about fetching for Dryad Arbor at the end of his turn. And if he either taps that Divining Top or plays a counterbalance, I do. That will give me a target for this Abrupt Decay. Which means I can't F6. Okay, so there's the counterbalance. Now the question here is, do I want to Abrupt Decay right away? Which, yes, we will, because we just probably want to untap and play the Knight. And he does have mana up to spend the top, so we're just not going to keep. So we're going to Abrupt Decay. Counterbalance did trigger. I don't know if he's going to reveal it or not. Probably not, because he doesn't have a fetch land. And he chose not to. Which was correct, I believe. Alright. Now, do we want to get Dryad Arbor? No, because we don't have any more lands, and if he Termuses, then we're off at 3 drops. Another Abrupt Decay is okay. We're going to get a Bayou here, and this Assemble Obzon. Alternatively, we could cast Mom and leave open Abrupt Decay. That's worse against Terminus, because we want to cast Knight on the next turn. It's better against potential Swords to Plowshares. There's also Jace to consider. F6. So if the Mom lives and the Knight resolves, then that means he has to be on Terminus. So he's gonna Swords Mom. So that's good. That's one less. That means he's not gonna snap Swords the Knight. This also gives me a target for one of these Swords to Plowshares in my hands. We're not going to play around Spell Pierce, because we want to play the Knight on the next turn, and we also have two of these. And Spell Pierce isn't that common. Okay. Right, instep. Swords. Target snap. Yep. Ugh. That's gross. So here's the Knight. It'll be a 4/4. It's a good clock. Can also get me Wastelands or Dark Depth combo pieces. We don't have any way to interact, so we'll just F6. Utada? Hey girl, when'd you get here? Oh. And there's the swords, of course. It's okay. So, this is a bad position because we don't have any action. We only have reactive cards. We want to be proactive in this matchup, and he has a top. And he has multiple fetch lands to shuffle. So, actually, you know, he might just be looking for, like, Entreat to just kill me and go to game two. If he plays it. Okay. So, this is a situation where we're definitely getting Dryad Arbor. Man, he has so many shuffles. I am so jelly of all his shuffles. I'm gonna call this guy Truffle. Egg Raid. It's not Egg Raid. You're the Truffle Shuffle King. the Truffle Shuffle King of Tokyo Pop Street. Alright, end step. Get a Dryad Arbor. Draw Jitay. Ha ha! Get in there! We only have two more fetchable lands in our library. Oh my gosh. Yeah, we've got... Oh no, that's terrible! I don't have Brainstorm to shuffle it back. Okay. We're gonna hold that Bayou for now. Go in there, Treebeard. Hiya. Though the fetch lands aren't dead, even if I end up drawing that forest. Because if he casts Terminus and Dryad Arbor goes back into my library, I can use the fetch lands to recur him. I'm just gonna go ahead and play the Bayou because I already have. There's no point in holding it in hand because I already have these three other cards that I have to hold in hand. So I'm not really giving myself any kind of advantage by just holding it. Alright, so we're just gonna go ahead and have six. While he ponders. He's playing the wrong ponders, by the way. Did you know there's a guy's face in the background of that? Ugh, so many ponders. I've never wanted a Miracles player to play creatures so badly. Cast a Mentor. Please cast a Mentor. Alright, so Scavenging Ooze is good. It's a threat. And it's also disruption for his Snapcaster Mages. We're going to attack first, though. See if he uses a Swords or any Terminus or anything else on this Dryad Arbor. Probably not. He's probably waiting to try and get a 2-for-1. And that was the case. We'll make sure we leave up the Savannas because we have two swords in our hand. Cast the Skews. Make sure we use the Scrubland so we have all our green mana open. Skews is good. Alright, no more F6ing. If he kills it, I want to activate it a couple times with the removal spell on the stack. Alright, so he's going to shuffle here. Probably pretty tempted to find a Terminus now. And he's going to shuffle again. That's weird. Could mean that he's going to Brainstorm at the end of my turn and put Entreat on top of the library. Uh-oh. We might be dead, guys. Oh, we might be so dead. Ha! Called it! Oh, I hate calling my own demise. I can actually kill three of them. So, kind of depends on how many he makes here. So he's making four and I can kill three. Although one is definitely enough to kill me. Okay. So here, we're going to Abrupt Decay 1 on the end of turn, and then wait for my turn to play the swords. That way we are playing around Spell Pierce, which, like I said, isn't that commonly played, but there's no reason to get wrecked and just die here when we might have a means to survive. And no, I do not like 3-for-1-ing myself to like this, but it is what it is. We also have a use for this mana. Always target the swords first. And notice he doesn't have mana open to snap swords in response, so I can't get blown out that way, which is good. Okay. So, we're going to hold that fetch land to get Dryad Arbor back after a Terminus. Oh, this is... I don't like this. Alright, swords. We want to do this now. We could try to do it in his upkeep. But then he gets to top and bounce top and draw cards and cast more cards. I think I just like doing it now.
Surely he lets the first one resolve, because he's... Yeah. Modern Masters 2017 Angel Tokens, huh? I see. I don't know why you can't get to pick... Why you don't get to pick your own tokens whenever you put a card in your deck. Whenever you're in the deck builder and you add a card to your deck that generates tokens, a window should come up and say, which of these tokens would you like to use? Seems silly. And again, there are a lot of things about Magic Online that are silly. Like the fact that I'm playing it right now when I should be at the gym! Or eating lunch. Come on. Come on. I don't know what's going on here. You could be thinking about a counterspell. You could have actual factual counterspell. You could have spell pierce, force. He could top and try to find something. But you've got two others. Maybe he's just AFK. Okay, so that was good. I'm just gonna immediately do it again. Yep, he might have F6'd. Alright, we can't attack. We will play... No, we'll hold the Verdant Catacomb since we're not gonna crack it. And we'll leave Scavenging Ooze up to counter any... Snapcaster Mages. So we're just gonna pass. Spend a top in his upkeep. So, because of all these sorts of postures, I'm actually got a lot of life, so that one angel is a pretty slow clock. Of course! You... Ugh! I hit 3-for-1 in myself. Okay. That's a problem. Oh, this is bad. He's got two tops? Oh, we are dead. He's got 3 mana open, so he can... this is bad. Alright, we're gonna F6 and then just turn off the auto yields at the end of his turn so we can activate Skooze a bunch of times. It's a little dangerous because of Snapcaster, but... I mean, I guess I could just... Alright, so let's always yield to this. Let's always yield to this. So now we just have to click through. I'm actually casting the top. Yep. Attack for 4. He might just leave open mana for like counterspell or swords, or just to spin the top, because he already has a pretty great board. Right, so let's exile some cards here. Start with the cantrips. I don't know if there's anything here that... Any... I guess I need, like, running Abrupt Decays to not die here. Can we just pass? If I attack with Skooze, all he has to do is cast one spell to either have a token trade with it or to just have the mentor block and kill it. this is bad.
We're very likely just dead here. Yeah. Alright, this is over. Because the only way I was going to win was with running Abrupt Decays, and it had to be before you made a bunch of tokens, so we can't win anymore. Alright, so on to game two. Conserving your clock is very important against Miracles. Alright, we want Pithing Needle, Winter Orb, Sword of Light and Shadow, Gaddock Teague, Reclamation Sage, Engineered Plague, Armageddon, Thalia, and Enlightened Tutor. We want to trim on swords, I believe. Moms are good, Stone Forges are good, that is good, Scooze is good, Silver Library is good, Replicates are good, Teagues and Pride Mages are good. Now, this is really rough. This matchup is, it's really hard to sideboard because you have a lot of good cards, but the way your deck's built just doesn't work against them. You, like, most of your cards are individually good. Huh. Right, so Jitay. Alright, so since we don't have Batterskull, actually, Stonefork Mystic is not that great. Sword of Fire and Ice is good, but we're going to trim. And then Knight of the Reliquary is like our Tarmogoyf in this matchup, so it's not as good. So we're gonna trim down to two. That gives us six slots. Alright, let's just take a look. Usually I have written out sideboard plans. We're not quite there yet. We can board out one of our mana dorks because of Terminus. They are good in the early game, but it's not typically how it works out against them. So, actually, we don't want to go down on Stoneforge Mystics because we do have Sword of Light and Shadow to go. Alright, so we'll board out a Pride Mage. Leave it as a... We'll just leave one Pride Mage as a Green Sun target. And maybe go down one more Swords. I kind of want to go down a Mom. It's hard to say. Engineered Plague. All right, we'll just try it. No worries. Egg Raid. Alright, we will play first. That's awkward. So, I like the Pithing Needle and the Wastelands. I don't like not having a white mana to cast Teague, but then again, he's probably... The first thing I cast is probably just going to eat a Swords of Potion anyway. So we're going to try it. Like I said, we are concerned about Blood Moon in game two, but this hand doesn't really let us play around it, so we're just not going to worry about it. So we're going to leave Bayou, cast Pithing Needle, and we're just going to name Sensei's Divining Top. There's some school of thought in just holding it until they actually cast the top, because you may rather have it to Jace the Mind Sculptor. They may not even play Jace. Sensei's Golden Tail. Yeah, that's a great idea. And we just want to use our mana efficiently, so we're just going to cast it now. Plus, we want to hopefully have the opportunity to activate some Wastelands. This deck does usually fetch for basics, but... So maybe I shouldn't have kept this hand. Thalia's... So, can play Wasteland, cast Scrub Ranger at the end of his turn, start attacking.
Red Dryad, I would go.
Yep. We don't want to show Wasteland yet. He's probably going to fetch basics anyway, but Legacy's all about small advantages, so you got to try and use like every scrap of information you have. Keep it to yourself as much as possible. Right, so he's going to Swords the Dryad Arbor, which is fine. Now white mana. That's sort of white mana. He does have a fetch land, so that's good. So we get to Wasteland the Tundra, and then play Deathrite Shaman. Like this. And we're going to have six. And he forced it. I'm a little annoyed just because I needed the white, but seems okay. Alright, now we're on Scrib Ranger beatdown plan. Oh, no, turn off auto yields, turn... No! Oh, gosh, I accidentally F6'd and didn't cast Scrib Ranger. Son of a monkey butt. Okay. So here... Oh, gosh, that's annoying. Gonna try to green some for a Deathrite Shaman here. It's a total punt. Total punt. Sometimes I just click through stuff. Happens. Aha! You're giving me white mana, I see. Uh oh. Mama, no! Mama, no! Please don't plow. Don't plow him. Aw. No, why'd you do that? Why'd you do that? Fluxcaster Mage Man? Scrib Ranger is actually pretty good against Snapcaster Mage. Alright, so we're actually safe to F6 here. Attack for 2, taking me to 20. So I keep getting plowed. Through a white spell. That's fine. Alright, so we're going to pass, and we're going to leave up Scrib Ranger and Wasteland. Hopefully he'll attack into my Scrib Ranger. He's not going to play around Scrib Ranger here. He's totally going to attack. Oh, he just straight just didn't play around Scrib Ranger. What a foo. What a foo. I need to make green. Oh, yes. Probably has a swords. No! Maybe he did play around Scrib Ranger. This is not going well. Ha. Huh. Okay. F6. Maybe this wasn't such a great keep. Essex. Even if he plays a non-basic, I don't want to wasteland him at the end of his turn. There's no upside to that. I'd rather do it on possibly my turn when I have more information, because I'll know what I've drawn.
Yep, there's the blood moon. Just like we said. So now we're not only off of white, but we're off of green. All right, we're just going to call it there. Update the old Excel sheet, and then that'll be it for now. I don't have a regular streaming time yet. Just going to be doing some pickup games in a league when we can. Maybe, hopefully, going to be streaming the Community Legacy League at some point. I probably will get set up with a regular streaming night. But thank you guys for watching. Once again, I'm Ryan, and I'm streaming for Four Horsemen Comics and Gaming. We're located in Morgantown, West Virginia, in the Morgantown Mall. So I have two other great locations, downtown in Waynesburg, Pennsylvania, and in the Meadowbrook Mall in Clarksburg, West Virginia. Once again, thank you for watching. I know we're all Mavericks. We're all Mavericks at heart.